In this video, I will show you how to create a road survey from drone data. The technique I will demonstrate today uses section lines. I'm going to walk you through the entire process, step by step. Keep watching. Step number one, the center line. The center line will determine the alignment of my section lines. I can easily trace this one by following the road markings. I will draw it with as few clicks as possible. Only in the turn, I'll make sure to capture the curve properly. A section line will be created later in each vertex of the center line. Step number two, the section lines. I need to determine how wide my road survey needs to be. So, I do a quick distance measurement. 80 feet will be wide enough. I select the center line, and in the section line group, I enter 80 feet as the across distance. I will also enter an along distance and create the section lines. You see that there are more section lines in the curve. Step number three, capture breaks. The section lines don't follow the terrain yet at this point. The densify feature allows me to capture this information. I set the densify method to breakpoints, and I make sure to set the elasticity low enough to capture enough detail. Then I press densify. The section lines fit well with the terrain now. Step number four, cleanup. At this point, I don't need the center line anymore, so I will turn it off. I see that some of my section lines are on top of the trees. I can easily clean them. I select the section line and click any button in the edit group. The vertices appear, and I will delete the ones that are on top of the trees. Oops, one too many. Undo. I decide to keep the last one and give it the same elevation as the vertex in front of the tree. I copy the elevation, paste it here, and enter. I continue to clean some other section lines. Step number five, the boundary. I want to confine my road survey to the limits of the section lines, so I will create a hull around them. I select my section lines, set the hull type to concave, and create the boundary. Step number six, the surface. Now I'm ready to create my surface. I select the boundary and triangulate within. The surface is created and is shown as triangles by default. I can also display it with contour lines or as contours only. I'm ready now to export the surface to a CAD file. As an extra, the culvert. You probably have noticed this culvert. We can include this in our survey. I enable the contour lens. Then I can easily trace over the concrete structure. At the bottom, I will draw the flow line. When the structure is complete, I triangulate again. Thank you for watching. Continue to watch some of our other videos, or click the logo to subscribe to the channel and keep up with future releases.